Well, it's Thursday morning, so that means it's time for a look at what's making news in the entertainment world. And joining us once again is Ange Bishop on the desk. Ange, Pink Floyd's making a comeback.
And I know you love your Floyd.
Yeah.
And they've got this juggernaut going because they're re-releasing their entire back catalogue and they're on a relentless promotional campaign to back it up. So last night, Roger Waters appeared on Late Night with Jimmy Fallon and performed the band's hit In the Flesh with none other than the Foo Fighters.
Is this not what you expected to see? If you want to find out what's behind these cold eyes, you just have to claw your way through this disguise.
And Roger Waters will be bringing his live tour of The Wall to Australia in February. A reality TV contestant will front court accused of spitting on her hairdresser during a disagreement over the bill. Security cameras at the South Bank salon appear to show comedian Anne Ferguson Howe screaming abuse at the stylist before spitting in her face. After being booed off stage on Australia's Got Talent, she threatened to do the same to celebrity judge Brian McFadden.
Go. You said you'd spit on him in the paper today.
Because that was disgusting. I'd have a spit on anybody. I said that in the heat of the moment. That's a revolting thing to do.
The woman will appear in court in Brisbane next month. Her alleged victim has undergone disease testing and is awaiting the results. He's one of the most versatile men in Hollywood, starring in action movies one minute, singing and dancing on Broadway the next. But when Hugh Jackman comes home to Australia, he just wants to hit the beach. I spoke to him ahead of the premiere of his new film, Real Steel, last night.
Well, Hugh, welcome home.
Thank you.
I can't believe you got off the plane and had time for a dip yesterday.
I always do it.
You miss Bondi that much, do you?
I love it, and it's the best jet lag cure there is.
Yeah.
Particularly when it's like 16, 17 degrees in the water.
Oof. Look, congratulations on Real Steel.
Thank you.
I have to admit, I had a little trepidation going on set. I thought, okay, it's going to be a bit of a boys' movie, the boxing robots and all the rest. And I loved it. Not only I loved it, I cried.
Yeah, I know.
Now, nobody warned me. Nobody said that. It was
That's
great.
What Deb said to me. She's like, you were doing this movie the whole time. I thought, oh, Oscar's going to like it.
Yeah.
But she said, I cried. She started hitting me. As I looked at her and she goes, stop it. Yeah, I was not ready for that.
Let's finish him.
Gravity slam, uptown!
Now, these robots, explain to me, were they CGI, were they real? How did they work?
Half of the time they are real robots.
Wow.
So about six of the robots were built full size, but are just shells, don't operate in any way. But four of them are fully operational. So if they're not walking or if they're not fighting, that's a real robot you see in the movie. So
You've
they
got
move,
one at
they're
home.
Lit up.
You've got one at home. Did
I
you take one
to nick
home?
It. It's not easy to get in the boot. Trust me, 9-foot robot. Heavy too.
And you play not the world's greatest father. You would not be father of the year in this film. But what a stretch for you. Because we know you're a pretty good dad.
And every parent knows there are times
there is a
where
moment.
You want to say things that if it actually came out of your mouth, you would regret for the rest of your life. I've walked out of rooms sometimes. I've hit pillowcase. Like, being a parent, I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're Gandhi. There are moments where you want to lose it. And so for 3 months in this movie, everything that I pushed down came out. That poor kid, Dakota, I just unleashed everything. You know, it was great therapy.
So you're going from this great action, really macho movie straight onto Broadway again.
Yes.
I love the way your life is a constant juxtaposition.
Two sides. I don't know if you've seen Saturday Night Live.
Yes.
There's a guy who takes me off and he's got this talk show called Two Sides because I'm masculine and I'm feminine.
Some of you may know me as the Wolverine. Others may know me
as the guy who hosted the Tonys.
Yes, I like to mix it up. So next is Broadway, and then I'm doing the movie musical of Les Mis with Russell Crowe. And
yeah, so you're Valjean, he's Javert. How does
he's
it work?
Javert, and it was phenomenal. And then after that, back to Wolverine. So it's an eclectic year. This is actually, for me, this is where I'm in my zone.
Have you actually worked with Russell before?
No. No, I mean, I know him very well.
Yeah, sure.
We sung together on the stage at Opera. I still call Australia home.
You
that was
did?
Our biggest. That's right. I had a few stitches in my head at the time, so I don't remember
right.
much of it.
How did you recover from all of that?
It was good. It was a good excuse to go and get some surgery. No. Blade on the eye.
Premiere tonight. You're looking forward to walking your home red carpet?
Exactly. It's always, and I'm really excited about watching the movie with my mates, and particularly with my dad, because my dad was a boxing champion.
What?
In 1955, the army champion, and he never talked to me about boxing because my brother and I used to beat each other up. So he thought, I better not talk about it. So I know he's a huge, I know he's going to love it.
Forget about the next story, eh? He just seemed like a bit of a fan with you. Loved interviewing
him on
the
red
carpet.
Yes, he's very good.
Gave you a kiss too. Anyway, keep going.
Thanks very much, Tash. Yes, and Real Steel is in cinemas next week. Fans of American actor John Wayne will get to own a piece of Hollywood history when his estate goes up for auction next month. Among the prized possessions of the Duke are the eye patch from his 1969 film True Grit and the Golden Globe Award he won for that movie. John Wayne starred in more than 170 films. He died of stomach cancer in 1979 at the age of 72. Ashton Kutcher has been accused of cheating on his wife Demi Moore on the weekend of their six-year wedding anniversary. A 23-year-old woman is claiming she slept with the star last Friday after an alcohol-fueled night at a San Diego bar. Demi has not helped the rumours either, tweeting a philosophical quote that says, "When we are offended at any man's fault, turn to yourself and study your own failings, then you will forget your anger." It comes as America's Star magazine claims the pair's marriage is officially over, due to Kutcher's serial cheating. So there you have it,
Tash.
Quite
an interesting quote there from Demi.
It was. Yeah. It just rolls off the top of the head, I think.
We'll just think about that for a moment. Thanks so much, Ag.